For example, the likes of General Carlos Garcia. 20 years ago, would we have something like that in the military, someone like that in the military, when corruption was also bad during Marcos's time?
Well, the only remaining resources, let me answer it obliquely, no? We have now, are our almost unlimited access to information and our human resources. I think these two strengths have come to bear on issues like the Garcia case. But our people are not to be fooled. General Garcia, or retired General Garcia, or former General Garcia, never signed contracts. Whatever he amassed in 20 or so bank accounts, I'm not prejudging the case, no? I'm just saying that it stands to reason that there are others as culpable or more culpable who are getting away. What am I saying? Maybe it is time for issues like this to surface and let the public judge. But let us follow standards and procedures. That was part of what EDSA tried to rebuild from the ashes of a bureaucracy that Marcos tried to turn into his private domain. We had more transparency, especially in media. In fact, if you don't mind my saying so, I'm just using media as an example of what the institutional damage that has happened in other sectors, no? Whenever media is asked to come up with a list of the 10 most corrupt, I notice it never includes itself, when it should be maybe number one or number two, in the top three at least. No. What I'm saying is there is the law of nature that allows you to defend itself. The military is not an exception. The bureaucracy is not an exception. The presidency is not an exception. This is part, again, of the second problem we have to face, which is institutional damage. And I guess I have no complaints in the sense that we have nowhere to go but up.